What is hepatitis B? Hepatitis B is a potentially life-threatening liver infection caused by the hepatitis B virus, known as HBV. It can cause both acute and chronic infection. It's very contagious and can be spread from one person to another. What is the hepatitis B classification? Well, acute hepatitis B virus infection is a short-term illness that occurs within the first 6 months after someone is exposed to the hepatitis B virus. Chronic hepatitis B virus infection is a longer-term illness that occurs when the hepatitis B virus remains in a person's body. You might be asking yourself, well, who's at risk for hepatitis B? People who have sex with an infected person, have multiple sex partners, have a sexually transmittable disease, are men who have sexual contact with other men, inject drugs or share needles, syringes, or other drug equipment, live with a person who has chronic hepatitis B, are infants born to infected mothers, are exposed to blood on the job, are hemodialysis patients, or travel to countries with moderate to high rates of hepatitis B. So how common is hepatitis B in the United States? First, let's look at acute hepatitis B. Since routine hepatitis B vaccination has been available, acute hepatitis B rates have declined by approximately 82% since 1991. And the disease in the United States has dramatically declined, particularly among children. In 2014, there were an estimated 19,200 new hepatitis B virus infections in the United States. The official number of reported hepatitis B cases is much lower because many people don't know they are infected or may not have symptoms and therefore never even seek the attention of medical or public health officials. Chronic hepatitis B in the United States is an estimated 850,000 to 2.2 million persons here in the U.S. Globally, chronic hepatitis B affects approximately 240 million people and contributes to an estimated 786,000 deaths worldwide every year. Hepatitis B is spread when blood, semen, or other body fluid infected with the hepatitis B virus enters the body of a person who is not infected. People can become infected with the virus during activities like birth, where it's spread from the infected mother to her baby during the birth process, sex with an infected partner, sharing needles, syringes, or other drug injection equipment, sharing items such as razors or toothbrushes with an infected person, direct contact with the blood or open sores of an infected person, and exposure to blood from needle sticks or other sharp instruments. Now let's discuss the hepatitis B incubation period. The incubation period for hepatitis B ranges between 45 to 160 days, but on average is at about 120 days. Now let's discuss the signs and symptoms of acute hepatitis B. They could include fever, fatigue, loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, dark-colored urine, clay-colored stool or bowel movements, joint pain, and jaundice, which is a yellow color in the skin or the eyes. Symptoms usually last a few weeks, but some people can be ill for as long as 6 months. Now let's talk about chronic hepatitis B. Some people have ongoing symptoms similar to acute hepatitis B, but most individuals with chronic hepatitis B remain symptom-free for as long as 20 or 30 years. About 15 to 25% of people with chronic hepatitis B develop serious liver conditions, such as cirrhosis, or scarring of the liver, or even liver cancer. Even as the liver becomes diseased, some people still do not have symptoms, although certain blood tests for liver function might begin to show some abnormalities. The number one way to test for hepatitis B is through a blood test. When taking blood tests, we're looking for hepatitis B surface antigen, known as HBsAg. HBsAg is a protein on the surface of the hepatitis B virus. It can be detected in the blood during acute or chronic hepatitis B virus infection. the body normally produces antibodies to HBsAg as part of the normal immune response to this infection. A positive test means a person has an acute or chronic hepatitis B virus infection and can pass the virus to others. A negative test means a person does not have the hepatitis B virus in his or her blood. Hepatitis B surface antibody, or anti-HBs, is an antibody that is produced by the body in response to the hepatitis B surface antigen. A positive test means a person is protected or immune from getting the hepatitis B virus for one of two reasons. Either one, he or she was successfully vaccinated against hepatitis B, or two, he or she recovered from an acute infection and can't get hepatitis B again. Total hepatitis B core antibodies, or anti-HBC, is an antibody that is produced by the body in response to a part of the hepatitis B virus called the core antigen. The meaning of this test often depends on the results of two other tests, anti-HBs and HBsAg. A positive test means that a person is either currently infected with the hepatitis B virus or was infected in the past. IgM, antibody to hepatitis B core antigen, or IgM anti-HBC, is used to detect an acute infection. A positive test means a person was infected with hepatitis B virus within the last 6 months. Hepatitis B E antigen, or HBeAg, is a protein found in the blood when the hepatitis B virus is present during an active hepatitis B virus infection. A positive test means a person has high levels of virus in his or her blood and can easily spread the virus to others. This test is also used to monitor the effectiveness of treatment for chronic hepatitis B. Hepatitis B E antibody, or HBeAb, or anti-HBe, is an antibody that is produced by the body in response to the hepatitis B E antigen. A positive test means a person has chronic hepatitis B virus infection, but is at lower risk of liver problems due to low levels of hepatitis B virus in his or her blood. Hepatitis B viral DNA refers to a test to detect the presence of hepatitis B virus DNA in a person's blood. A positive test means the virus is multiplying in a person's body and he or she is highly contagious and can pass the virus to others. If a person has a chronic hepatitis B virus infection, the presence of viral DNA means that a person is possibly at increased risk for liver damage. This test is also used to monitor the effectiveness of drug therapy for chronic hepatitis B virus infection. Now let's take a closer look at the treatment of hepatitis B. First, the treatment for acute hepatitis B. There is no medication available, and it's best addressed through supportive treatment. During this short-term infection, doctors usually recommend rest, adequate nutrition, fluids, and sometimes hospitalization. For chronic hepatitis B, regular monitoring for signs of liver disease progression, oral medications including oral antiviral agents like tenofovir or entecavir, the most potent drugs to suppress hepatitis B virus and rarely leads to drug resistance, are used. How do we prevent hepatitis B? Well, first is through hepatitis B vaccination. And this is a sequence of shots that stimulate a person's natural immune system to protect against HBV. After the vaccine is given, the body makes antibodies that protect a person against the virus. Hepatitis B vaccination is recommended for all infants, starting with the first dose of hepatitis B vaccine at birth. All children and adolescents younger than 19 years of age who have not been vaccinated. People whose sex partners have hepatitis B, sexually active persons who are not in a long-term mutually monogamous relationship, persons seeking evaluation or treatment for a sexually transmitted disease, men who have sexual contact with other men, people who share needles, syringes, or other drug injection equipment, people who have close household contact with someone infected with the hepatitis B virus, healthcare and public safety workers at risk for exposure to blood or blood-contaminated body fluids on the job, people with end-stage renal disease, including pre-dialysis, hemodialysis, peritoneal dialysis, and home dialysis patients. Residents and staff of facilities for developmentally disabled persons. Travelers to regions with moderate or high rates of hepatitis B. People with chronic liver disease. People with HIV infection. And anyone who wishes to be protected from hepatitis B virus infection. In order to reach individuals at risk for hepatitis B, vaccination is also recommended for anyone in or seeking treatment from the following: sexually transmitted disease treatment facilities, HIV testing and treatment facilities, facilities providing drug abuse treatment and prevention services, healthcare settings targeting services to injection drug users, healthcare settings targeting services to men who have sex with men, chronic hemodialysis facilities and end-stage renal disease programs, correctional facilities, and institutions and non-residential daycare facilities for developmentally disabled persons.